NASA finds life before you try to kill it. And today, Space Force got a boost from Vice President Mike Pence. No surprise, Pence is a huge fan of space. It is the farthest you can get from being alone with a human woman. Mm-hmm. Now, yes. In a speech to the Defense Department, Pence outlined the mission that will take us to the stars.
President Trump proclaimed that the United States stands, in his words, at the birth of a new millennium.
From being alone with a human woman. Not to mention his most glaring lie of all, saying Don Jr. is wonderful. With his tendency to cheat on facts, it's no wonder Trump's lawyers don't want the president to sit down for an interview with special counsel Robert Mueller. And the folks on Fox News agree.
How in the world could he?
Wonderful.
Suddenly, you are too sick or too injured to
work. Truck month, make no monthly payments for 9 months.
At her house as a family. Uh-huh. And, you know, my brothers came over and she went upstairs. She didn't watch it. She was like, I can't. And so I was genuinely hurt. Like, wow, you're really not going to watch this show that I made? And then. Just last month, she caved and she was like, okay, I decided to watch all the episodes. I love it. It wasn't too much for me. And now she likes the show. So oh, I did
that's
it.
That's nice. Because ultimately, it's all from mom.
It's all
from mom.
I do it all
it's
from
all
mom.
It's all from mom.
That's all I want.
Well, the season three of Insecure, it starts this Sunday?
It starts this Sunday, 10:30.
What's the season about? Give us some idea of the season.
This season is about adulting. You know, it's about our characters learning how to know better and do better. Because they've made a lot of mistakes. They've made a lot of poor decisions, which may or may not be based on decisions I've made with my friends. But there gets a point when you're in your 20s, people are like, oh, So Issa's best friend, Molly, has just come back from vacation. And she's explaining, you know, how she just, I don't remember. Watch it.
I think this is the porn part. This is the porn.
I remember now. Yes. Exactly.
Exactly. Is that exactly. Scene right there?
Yeah, that was
cool. And your friends have to recognize themselves, right?
Oh, my friends totally do. Yeah.
Your character's name is Issa, and you're Issa. Does that ever get confusing? Because I played someone named Steven for a long time.
Yes.
Does that ever confuse your fans in any way?
It absolutely does. You know, they attack me personally. Via social media.
Really?
You know, they call
don't
names
go on
and things.
Social media.
I try not to. I try to take breaks. But, you know, it's hard. It's already hard for people to separate you from characters. But it's my fault. I should have never named the character after me. I just wasn't thinking.
Mm-hmm. It's not too late to give your character a nickname.
Like what? What do
Buddy?
You recommend? Molly and Buddy. I don't know if that'll work, but I'll consider it. I think it is too late.
Well, now that you're an established, award-winning auteur in your own right, Do people come up asking for advice from you?
They do. I really don't know what to tell them because everybody's journey is...
Rated R, in theaters tomorrow.
Welcome to AT&T Innovations, where we give you more for your thing. And here's where we shrink the biggest names in entertainment so we can fit them into our unlimited wireless plan. Who's first?
No. This isn't permanent, right?
Ask him.
Being there when you're needed most.
He's the one.
Love is knowing.
Love is EGOT. No, I don't know if that's gonna happen. Big John Legend fan. Would be happy to bestow.
Are you gonna throw a party at your own piano bar in Los Angeles?
Oh, you know about my piano bar.
I've heard about it. Know about it, but I've heard about this place called Tramp Stamp Grannies.
You heard it, baby. That's the name.
And that's your bar.
That's it. That's me and my fiance. It's really her bar. I'm just the pianist. But that's our...
How did it get the name Tramp Stamp Grannies?
Just because every time you say it, it just puts a smile on your face. People mechanically, politely ask me, because, you know, they'll be like, oh, you open a bar, what's it called? And they kind of zone out, and I say Tramp Stamp Grannies very casually, and there's like this blah, 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 and they remember it. And
so what can I expect if I go to Tramp Stamp Grannies? What kind of evening is this going to be?
It's a piano bar. It's in honor of the many wonderful piano bars of New York City. Piano.